Assalamu alaikum wa barakatuh. Hello children, how are you today? Alhamdulillah. You're welcome to an exciting session. Inshallah, this time we're going to be finishing our story on Kisasul Anbiya. Is that clear? Have you gotten your books? Are you ready? Mashallah. So let's go to model 12. Are you model 12 now? Are you there? Very good. We're going to learn about Prophet who? Ayyuub. Prophet Ayyuub. So let's read together. His name was Ayyuub. His father was a descendant of Prophet Ibrahim, alayhi salam. His mother was the daughter of Prophet Lut. Did you know that before? Prophet Ayyuub's mother was who? The daughter of Prophet Lut. You remember Prophet Lut? The brother of Prophet Ibrahim. Remember we learned about Prophet Ibrahim in grade 1? When he left his people who were disbelievers. And only one man and one woman believed in him. Remember, the single man was Prophet Lut. Do you remember? MashaAllah. Allah says in the Quran, in Surah An'am, that was our proof which we gave Ibrahim against his people. We raise whom we will in degrees. Allah raises whomever he wills in degrees. Certainly, your Lord is all wise. Allah is all wise, Al Hakim, and all knowing, Al Alim. And we bestowed upon him Ishaq and Yaqub. Each of them we guided, and before him we guided Nuh, and among his progeny, Dawood, Suleiman, Ayyub, Yusuf, Musa, and Harun. Thus do we reward the good doers. Allah says, he raises whom he wills in degrees, and he guides them. And Prophet Ayyuub was among those Allah guided. If you want to learn, yes, if one wants to learn about patience, do you know what it means to be patient? When something is happening to you, you're not happy about it, you remain calm and put your trust in Allah. Perseverance, steadfastness. He didn't shake. His faith in Allah did not shake. He was very strong. He didn't think, oh, Allah has forgotten me. Oh, Allah is punishing me. Oh, why me? Why me? He was never complaining. And gratefulness. Prophet Ayyuub was a grateful servant of Allah, always thanking Allah. Did you thank your parents today? Did you thank Allah today? Did you thank him for everything, for the eyes you can use to see? Your years to year? Did you thank him for waking you up this morning? He was a grateful servant. Then one must study the history of Prophet Ayyuub. He witnessed all forms of trial and endured them. He endured every one of them. Allah tested him with sickness in his body. Allah took away all his children. Allah took away all his wealth. But he kept on saying, Alhamdulillah. He kept on saying what? Good, Alhamdulillah. He was never for once ungrateful. He was always patient and was always steadfast. Allah tried him with respect to his wealth, that is money. He lost all his money, livestock, all the animals, the cattle, the goats he had. Children, Allah took away his children and his health. Allah made him very, very sick. Very, very sick. We are yet to know of someone who has been afflicted with such from east to west. Allah also acknowledged his patience and steadfastness. Nobody in this whole world was afflicted like the way Prophet Ayyuub was afflicted. Nobody. And he was very, very patient. Allah says in Surah Al-Sad, truly we found him patient. How excellent a slave. Verily, he was oft returning in repentance to us. He was always repenting to Allah. He was always seeking Allah's forgiveness. Astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. Do we seek Allah's forgiveness? We must learn this from Prophet Ayyuub. Despite all afflictions, Prophet Ayyuub was always patient, steadfast, repentant, remembering Allah with thankfulness, was remembering Allah. At the end, Allah restored his health. Allah made him well again. He made his skin beautiful. His wealth and all the property he has lost. In this story of Prophet Ayyuub, we'll learn some lessons. Look down upon here. Can you see the lessons? Let's read them together. Allah says, so the lessons we learned about him is that it is good to be firm in trial. Look at what is happening now. Everybody's on lockdown. The pandemic is making everybody sad. People can't do things they like. We have to be what? Patient. And anything we are doing, whenever we lose anything and we are patient, Allah will give it back to us. Allah will give it back to us. We'll come back to school one day. We'll be happy. We'll be smiling. And Allah tries us in different ways. So some people, it takes their children. Some people, it takes their money. Some people, it takes their beauty. Different way Allah tries us. So I want you to look at the assessment question and do them and submit on Friday. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.